So my name is Kyle Bauer. I go by the creative name Tuhutzs. I'm a designer and an artist, and I live in the north of England in Saltburn by the sea. I work a lot with paintings, and I produce large format paintings, and also work a lot online with digital content and creating video and digital material as well.
So what led you to be doing what you're doing? What kind of inspired your practice? What got you started?
Yeah, I think just pursuing through art college and growing up in your 20s, thinking creatively, you fall into the path of being something or trying to be something. I guess there was never a point where I thought I'm going to be creative as a role. I guess I've always sort of felt creative. And then what I do with that feeling, in terms of it being a physical creation or maybe a digital creation, is just a representation of how I sort of feel creatively. So I guess the path of getting onto the creative route, it's something that I've just always felt.
And there is a connection there, like you said, between yourself and your work. And knowing you as an artist for a long time, that is a boundary that you push and blur. Can you talk a little bit about that? How you and the work connect?
Yeah, I think definitely that I'm almost sometimes a part of Tuhutzs, and Tuhutzs is not so much this type of content or this type of style. Sometimes I feel like I am a section of it, and that wasn't something that I consciously did, but I think the overall image of Tuhutz is quite integral to me as a person and my personality and as we were discussing earlier, my hair and my appearance and the way that I change things up and almost become a character or become a part of the genre that I'm looking at. I guess it's the feeling. So back to what we were saying earlier, the feeling of, I guess, because you feel like it's something that you want to do, and it's something that it's a feeling that you need to get out, you become part of what you're creating and you become it as well, because it's so connected with all your sensories that it isn't something so external. It's always going to be something that is almost a part of you.
Yeah, I agree. I think you can't decide when to be creative. You just are creative, and when you have that flowing through you, it's hard to separate yourself from your work sometimes.
Yeah.
And is that an issue that you feel you come across in your practice, the how interlinked you are with the work, and do you ever feel like you get too close to it? How do you take a step back sometimes to analyze your own practice?
Yeah, totally. I don't think I'm there yet where I can take a step back. I guess I'm there observing it. I'm there probably at the point now where I feel, how do I take a step back? I am too much a part of the work. How do I create something that doesn't involve some sort of personality to it? So this is something that I don't know really. It's something that I'll probably progress to find as the years go on. But definitely when I look at the overall shape of what I've created over so many years and what that identity gives to somebody that doesn't know me and how they look at it for the first time, generally I find that people will come to a conclusion that represents me in their mind different to how I feel I represent myself. So trying to be me, but then also trying to be a part of the whole experience that I'm creating artistically and through design sometimes gets blurred when you're losing who you are because you're almost becoming someone else. But like I said, it's a little bit like roles or characters. Like it's not meant to be permanent. You're not meant to be that person permanently. But I guess you do have a feeling and an overall sense of yourself when you're working on paintings or designs or something. and you're putting that message out there, you almost have to stand in front of it like, yeah, this is what I'm saying. And then you automatically become a part of it. I guess to be able to step back could be a very useful tool to be able to do. And I think, yeah, it will come in time. I think that will come in the time. But right now, I'm immersed in the work, and yeah. I don't know how to step back.
Yeah, I mean, when you're that immersed, you know, you don't want to take a step back, do you? You're in there. You're inspired. So going back to we were talking about your influences and inspirations. I can see your painting behind you, which looks a basura with the rubbish. Talk a little bit about the influence of the kind of the throwaway and this kind of rubbish and bins that I'm seeing in your work. Tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah, so the painting behind me is one of the basura paintings that I do. And I use the word basura, which in Spanish just means trash or garbage. And I really like the idea of a bin, and I've been using the bin as a subject genre for a while. And yeah, you said that throwaway kind of content. I think when I look at a bin, I look at it so different. And the way that they're displayed all over the planet in the most unusual places really gets my attention. And sometimes I imagine like just staring at that bin and looking at what's behind it. And the environment, you get to see the environment more than how we install these objects like in parts of this planet. We put things in there, like they don't grow from the ground. We like put them there. And then they contrast the environment, and the environment also contrasts itself. And then on top of that, these bins are generally filled or sometimes like in this painting, like pouring out with different items, and those items themselves have artwork and color and graphic formats, and you put all that together and you stick it in a bin, and you put that bin in a contrasted environment, all of a sudden it becomes quite an unusual image and something that always catches my eye. I like finding things that are not cool and making them cool, and I think cool is a big part of my work, and trying to make something fresh and something like that feeling you get when something's like really chilled and really, really, fresh. I think fresh is the best word, you know? And bins aren't like a cool subject, but bins are pretty cool and can look cool if you design them a certain way. So the bin concept and project is evolving. It's constantly growing, but I think it's pretty unique, and so far loads of great feedback and inspiration from other people, and everyone likes it, and everyone's on board with it, and everyone understands it. So it's definitely a good direction, and it excites me. Bins and painting bins seems to get me excited. I'm not sure exactly why, but that is like a driving force, really, in terms of a content to create.
I think it forms a really interesting kind of visual juxtaposition, you know, the kind of dualities you're talking about of something that kind of is, you know, it's disregarded, it's waste, and then to kind of, you know, inject that colour and that vibrancy into it, I think is really interesting. Talking about the present and the future, for Tuhutzs, what's next? What's now? What's happening?
Yeah, wow, what a question. So much ambitions and aspirations to achieve great things and to constantly keep pushing the focus point of what I'm looking at with my work. In terms of what's coming in the future, there's always things happening. I seem to be moving more towards design, and I've got a lot of design concepts coming out and conceptual websites coming out whereby you would interact with sort of machines that I've designed. And it's using a bit of photography, and a bit of editing, and a bit of drawing, and putting it all together. So it's very different from painting or working on a canvas. But I seem to be moving a lot more towards the digital aspect. And that's starting to come out in my paintings too, is that I'm looking a lot more at AI and artificial intelligence. I'm looking a lot more at consciousness and the idea that we're like brains inside a vat of water, and everything around us is electronic signals, and start looking a lot into what is this reality in front of us that we have here on Earth. And I think it spans from looking at bins and other aspects in unusual ways, and start to question, as many people are questioning, the idea of what is consciousness and what is our reality. And that, as I move forward into design, is spilling out into my work. And already I'm starting to look at concepts like loading tomorrow and painting things that was very different to what I was painting at the start of the year. So I'm moving in an area of artificial intelligence, understanding reality, and being quite, I want to be quite pioneering, I think, in terms of design. Like, these conceptual websites that I want to create will be very unusual for the format of being called a website. So it's using all skills, really. I think I'm never constant with one. I'm not going to say, well, I'm painting now, so I'm a painter for time. It's like, maybe tomorrow I want to do something completely bizarre, completely different outside of that. And so whatever fresh approaches come to me, I want to like move into them. And so you can just accumulate a large body of tools and skills that you can deploy at any time. I think it's a good way, but yeah, inspired for the future, I would say.
Well, I think it sounds interesting and relevant, and I'm really interested to see where it goes. I know we're working on some little pieces together in the near future, which will already be kind of history by the time this goes out. But so I just want to finish on a question regarding lockdown. And I just wonder how, if at all, lockdowns affected your practice. How have you functioned as an artist during these last few months?
Yeah, I guess it's been a huge process for everyone, and how people felt at the beginning, the middle, the end, and how they're feeling now. What is a beginning and what is an end, and what is this idea of reality that I was talking about before at AI is even more questionable now and relevant now as to what is happening. Nobody really knows what is happening. So to be able to absorb all of that in and to continue living your life has been quite tough for everybody. And creatively, I think you can use that. And I guess a lot of people, I think most of the world's probably starting to become creative now because of having a lot of free time with lockdown. But for me, I've been working, it's given me time to work on ideas and things that I wanted to do that I was sort of pushing back. Like, I'll do it tomorrow, or I'll do it in a few weeks. And when all of a sudden you can't do something for so long, you start to realize that you should have done it earlier, or you should have seized the moment when you couldn't do it. So I have this almost this relentless attitude now of to pursue your creativity is if you have 5 years left, like, and go for it, and don't keep waiting, because maybe next week there could be a lockdown where you can't exhibit, or you can't buy the materials you need, so you can't do those things. So it's given me an attitude like that. And how, in terms of how it's affected me, just with the idea of being able to travel between different continents and to use air flight to be able to go places and be inspired by different parts of the world, that has been removed. And no time that I know of was I not being able to get a flight. Like, if I have an idea to go somewhere, I just go to that place. And not one point did I think I might not be able to like fly there. So it's pushed me back more where I am. So I'm here in England, and it's made me more observant as to where I am and use what I have around me, as opposed to dreaming of ideas and tropical lands that might inspire me, or some sort of concept of places abroad. But I've managed to remain strong, and I feel like I'm in a good place and ready to bounce back out of this lockdown and present work to people with this new idea of looking at consciousness, reality, and AI, and bins, and what's really going on around us. And maybe now people are a lot more open to new thought processes too after the lockdown, and people can really start to absorb all this new type of artwork that's probably going to come out of these 3-4 months where people have been harbored up, creating, thinking, and stuff. There's going to be loads. So I'm just a part of this huge process, I think, now. But everything is positive.
Absolutely. Well, Tuhutzs, it's been a pleasure. Thank you for talking to me.
That's cool.